Welcome back to this week's episode of CTV.
Next week, we get to drive our snowmobiles to school. Check it out.
Sweet on CTV, we checked out the snowmobiles. Check it out.
I'm here with Kai Bus. Now, what's going on February 3rd?
February 3rd is Snowmobile to School Day. It's a day where everyone can go out and take their snowmobile and ride it to school, following the rules, of course.
What are those rules?
Oh boy, let's see, shall we? You should enter the school campus from the west, coming up the hill. Arrive between 7:30 and 7:35 to take pictures. Stay on the north side of the painted lines near the playground, and don't ride close to the elementary playground. You have to park along the painted lines on the west practice field. Come into the school by 7:50 and be on time for first hour. When you're leaving, exit to the west down the hill. Don't ride through the parking lots.
Oh. If you're going to be coming to ride your snowmobile school day, make sure to show up for Mr. Birdcourse's Flex Thursday, January 26th or February 2nd. So we'll keep you updated. Thank you.
Wow, that was really cool. Now back to the nest.
That looks like fun.
You know what else is fun?
Dress up days.
Now let's go find out what the dress up days are.
This week on CTV, we did a Snow Week dress-up preview. Check it out. On Monday, wear your class color, and it's anything but a backpack day.
Freshmen's going to be wearing orange, sophomores pink, juniors purple, and seniors blue.
Monday is also Snow Week coronation day. Tuesday is future day.
Plan to either wear your college attire or future occupation attire.
On Wednesday, wear your outdoor fits.
Bring your camel, flannel, or outdoor apparel.
Wednesday is also our class activity day.
On Thursday, it is
pajama day.
On Friday, our dress-up day is
jersey day.
It's also snowmobile to school day.
Make sure everyone participates. Back to the nest.
We hope to see a lot of good outfits next week.
Now let's go check out what the Snow Week activities are.
This week on CTV, we went around and asked people what their class activities were. Check it out.
We are here with
Josh Hansen.
What is your class activity?
Sledding behind the school. You should bring your own sleds, and there will be a place to put your sled throughout the day.
Thank you.
Okay, this week on CTV, I'm here with
Zach.
Marcos.
And can you tell me more about what class activity you're doing for Snow Week?
The sophomores are going to Empire Bowl and bowling, and it's $4 per person.
We're going to be playing two games, and when you pay, you can select your team of four.
Thank you. This week on CTV, I'm with
Sarah Steginga.
And can you tell me more about the class activity?
For the juniors, we're going to the ice arena to go skating. The cost for all juniors is $2, and if you have skates, you can bring them. Otherwise, there will be some available there.
Thank you.
We are here with
Ross Bergman.
Can you tell us a little bit more about your class activities?
Sure. All right, so next Wednesday, we are heading to Great Bear. The fee is $5, and there's an online waiver to fill out. When you go, make sure you wear your snow gear for the class picture, and the bus will leave at 12:10 and be back by 3 o'clock. Thank you.
We are here with
Keaton Hart
and Marcus Forthams.
Okay, how can students sign up for the activities?
Students will sign up for the activities today through Friday, and they will pay for the activities that cost money tomorrow through Friday, either before school, lunch, in the commons, or after school.
Thank you. And what will students do if they do not want to participate in their activity?
They will have a study hall or reading time with no charge.
Thank you. And that's all. Back to the nest.
That looks like fun.
One of our teachers got a very special award last week. Let's go check it out with Ashton and Andy.
On this week of CTV, we interviewed a new Hall of Fame coach, Mr. Winninger. Check it out. Hey, Mr. Winner, we recently received news that you were inducted into the Baseball Coaches Hall of Fame. Can you elaborate on how that happened?
Yeah, well, I was told by the Coaches Hall Association, they told us about 6 months ago. They went back and did some background information on us, checked out our records, past successes, state tournament appearances, things like that, to kind of give us a clue. We got to be able to spend the day at Target Field in the middle of winter. It was a beautiful day. You could see snow on the field. They introduced seven of us that made it to the 2023 class, and there's a lot of great people there, a lot of great inductions there from the other Hall of Famers. But more importantly, how this happened, I guess, is because Laverne has been so strong in their community involvement with baseball. We have a beautiful field. We have so many great people with the school and administration working together. Our activities director is top notch. We have opportunities to have things that a lot of schools don't. We have 3 indoor batting cages. But most importantly, obviously, in order to be, a coach that's qualified for this or can even say that they are, is having good players and other good coaches around them. The coaches that I've had with me, the assistant coaches, have been fantastic. So that makes my job a lot easier. So I guess it's just a little bit of icing on the cake for those people that are around you that are good. I suppose if you're people that aren't around you that aren't qualified, I guess I can't be either.
Great job.
Thanks.
Congratulations, Mr. Winninger. Now back to the nest.
Congrats, Mr. Winninger.
Now let's go to sports.
We're back with another week of
sports. Check it out.
This week, the boys' wrestling team fell short to Wyndham 39-43 and Worthington 33-45, with Sam and DJ Rock winning both of their matches.
This week, the girls beat Jackson 80-50 with a team effort of multiple 10 and over points scorers.
This week, the boys' basketball team fell short 64-83 against Jackson, with Gannon Arndt scoring 16 and Carter Sayre scoring 20.
This week, girls' hockey beat Minnesota River 4-0 and New Ulm 4-1, with Cameron Mavitavia becoming the third girl ever in Minnesota history to score a 400-point career.
This week, the boys' hockey team beat Fairmont 7-1 with Brock scoring 3, Dahmer scoring 2, Maddox scoring 1, Brady scoring 1, and beat Albert Lee 4-2 with Brock, Blake, Patrick, and Brady scoring 1 goal apiece.
Gymnastics. The girls this week went and beat Jackson for the first time ever in a score of 134.6, with Amir Cowell and Ella Reisdorfer leading the way.
That was an amazing week of sports.
Now, back to the nest.
Great job with sports last week.
Hope everyone has a good snow week. See you next week.